different. When challenges come to us, we will look at them in a different way because we have a different perspective. And I would like to take you to one of my favorite chapters in the Bible, which is Philippians chapter 4. Okay? Philippians chapter 4, I would just like to say, to read verse 4. Amen? And probably you have started this verse so many times, especially as apostolics who tend to, every time somebody does praise or worship, they always say, rejoice! So I think you're very familiar with this verse. But verse number 4, okay, the scripture we're going to read. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say, rejoice. Okay? So I just wanted to repeat that with me today. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say, rejoice. Amen? So if we can just close our eyes at this moment, and we're just going to pray God's anointing upon the word of God. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, I thank you so much, O God, for giving me this privilege to come before you, before your people. Jesus, we ask you, O God, that you will speak to us. That your sovereign spirit, O God, will move in our hearts, in our minds, O God, that we will not be just hearers, but that we will be doers of your word, Jesus. And that we will apply it, O God, and that we will leave this place different. That we will take things into our heart, O God, and that your spirit will change us, O God, today. Let your word be established in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So this chapter 4, I consider chapter 4 of this book, Philippians, the book of Philippians, to be for me, is one of my secret books, I call it, one of my secret chapters. Because in everything that I do, I try to live, well, everything that I do is not that I always get it right. I always get it wrong. But I try to apply the word of God in situations when I'm facing difficult situations, or when I'm facing doubt, or when I'm facing fear, or when I'm facing sickness, or when I'm facing, you know, whatever life throws at you. But for me, one of the key things in my Christian work is rejoicing. Rejoicing. And I think that rejoicing is more than just showing a happy face or showing that you're always smiling, you know. But it has to be within inner you. It has to be that level of joy that just abundantly flows. You know, we have it's like if I give you a cup, a glass of water, and then in the glass, for example, you take a glass and you ask somebody to serve you water in the glass, and the person who's serving you is just pouring out the water in the glass, and the water just flowing. You know, it's just flowing. And I think the joy of the Lord must just flow. And that comes only when we understand that the Lord, that the joy of the Lord is our strength. We can rejoice only when we know that the joy of the Lord is our strength. Yeah. We can rejoice in the Lord in the good times, in the bad times, in times of question, in times when we don't know, in times when we just have a question mark. We can just rejoice in the Lord because we know that He is our joy. Amen. That He is our strength. Amen. That He is our peace. That He is a sovereign God. And whatever He's doing around us is going to be okay if I just learn to rejoice. And the key of rejoicing is that it's not an option, but it is a choice. Okay? In other words, every time you wake up in the morning, you have to choose to rejoice. Okay? It has, because you wake up, for example, in the morning, you may have back pain, you're like, oh my goodness, I already have back pain, or you have a headache, or you think about the day that you're going to be facing, you're going to be having meetings, or you're going to be having, a certain meeting, certain people, or, you know, you just think about what's ahead of you. But if you wake and then you think this, you can choose right there. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna have an awkward day. I'm gonna have, you know, the most stressful day ever. But if you change it around and say, I will rejoice. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. I will. So it's a choice you make every day to say, I will rejoice in the Lord. Amen? It's about emphasizing. It's about applying the word of God. It's about saying, Jesus, I need your help to rejoice today. Because I'm not rejoicing about what is happening around me, but I'm rejoicing in you, in knowing you, that you are the great God. Amen? And now verse number 5 in the same chapter, which I want to take you around, is it says, let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Okay? Yeah. And then I couldn't understand the verse which said let your moderation, but in Spanish what it says don't be stressed. Don't worry about it, you know? Keep calm. Keep still, you know? Be relaxed, you know? Let people know your God. If we rejoice, then people will know our God. Haven't you ever been in a place, probably in your workplace, where you're just singing praises to the Lord, or you just look happy, or you're just happy? You're a happy person. You are rejoicing. And then people at work will say to you, what's wrong with you, you know? The whole world is calming them, you know, they're stressed to their nails. And then you are. You can be you're in the same storm as they all are, but then you have that inner peace. Because you know what? Because God wants the joy of the Lord to shine through you and for people to know who He is. Amen? In verse number 6, it says, be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made unto God. And I really like this verse, you know, because the Bible says that, you know, the way we communicate with God, the way we talk to Him is by prayer. And in the book of Psalms, David wrote this famous psalm, which I love also, which says, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. And I'm not saying that you just pray to the Lord when your heart is overwhelmed, but you pray to the Lord every single minute, every single day, every single time you get to talk to Him. It has to become a normal conversation you have with Him. But it says, but be careful for nothing. In other words, you know, don't hesitate to pray. Don't worry about praying, even if it's the most silliest thing that you ever think. God is ready to hear you. God is ready to answer you. God is just ready to hear your voice. And that's the beautiful thing. I know many of us will say, but God knows my heart. God sees the words from my mind. He knows my intentions. Yes, He does. Yes, He does. But He wants us to make an effort for us to verbally declare our request. But the key here is not just to make a request. Not just to come to the Lord in prayer and say, God, I'm fed up. I am so stressed about this. I am so mad at this. Blah, blah, blah. The key here, it says, make your request, prayer, supplication, with thanksgiving. Amazing, isn't it? And we come back again to rejoicing. With thanksgiving. You know, the Lord always wants you to give Him, to think positive. You know? Even though the situation may seem a bit, you know, dark and a bit chaotic, see the positive side of it, that you're coming to pray to a God that can hear you. Yeah. A God that will answer you. Probably God will perform a miracle right there. You know, when you leave that prayer room, God will perform a miracle right there. Or we'll do it in the next hour, or we'll do it in the next day, or He will do it at the right time. But if you're grateful to the Lord by saying, God, I know you heard my prayer, and I'm giving you thanks in advance, Because you're going to give me an answer. And I will rejoice. And I will say again, thank you, Jesus. And then we move to verse number 7. And it says, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. You know, one of the biggest battles that we face nowadays, I think, in the Western world, I think is the battle of the mind. The devil bombards you on a daily basis. I don't think it's days or I think it's seconds. In a second, your mind can be thinking something godly, and afterwards your mind can be thinking something evil. Because the devil will just shoot evil thoughts to come to your mind for you to start thinking evilish against your brother, against your sister, against you, the people you work around with, and just to look at the negative side, never to look at the positive side. But then here, Jesus Christ is saying, he says, but the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. You know what, one of the most amazing prayers that David, King David prayed, because even though he was a king of, you know, he had a high position, let's call it like that. But he always prayed a prayer, said, create in me a clean heart, a renew a right spirit within me. And the reason why is because every day, every minute, we need to ask the Lord to create within us a clean heart. Because this heart, you know, is a human heart. And this heart will just want to do its own thing. We just want to destroy. We just want to entertain the things that the enemy is throwing. But we must just ask the Lord to help us. Because Jesus Christ says here, and the peace of God will be with us. First of all, if we learn to rejoice. If we learn to say thank you, Jesus. That the peace of God will be with us. Amen. And then I want us to go to verse number 13 on the same chapter, which I think this is like the icing of the cake of the Apostle Paul's letter when he wrote. And he says, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Isn't that lovely? So after the Apostle Paul was able to kind of emphasize to the people, to the Philippian church, he was able to give them the greatest advice that he could ever give, the greatest mentorship to the Philippian church. He says to them, now, if you're on your own, I'm not going to be with you, I'm not going to tell you, you know, this is what you have to do, this is what you don't need to do. Now, it's on your terms, you and God, where you can say, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Amen. And I was listening to this preacher guy, and I forgot his name. Sorry, I was reading a book. But I read a book through audio book. Yeah, in the mornings. So I'm a bit lazy. I don't know what my eyes can see too. But this guy.